Hey, yo, Nick, are there any good apps for that Windows phone? That sinking market share on Windows phone? Is there any good apps I can download on my Windows phone? Well, what's up, guys? This is Nick here from Everything Tech, and today we're going to talk about my top 10 apps for Windows mobile devices. So I did customize them and put them all in this folder right here so you can see what I use here. And basically, these are my top 10 apps. There you go. That's the end of this video. Goodbye. No, I'm just messing with you. But here we go. Number one is Hyperlapse, real quick. So in Hyperlapse, this is basically going to give you a time lapse for the Windows phone device. So you press record and it'll go in 4x. You also have a flash. So if it's nighttime, you could turn on the flash to get a hyperlapsing going on there, or time-lapsing, whatever you want to call it, same thing. And let's come back out and let's look at my next app on the list. I don't want to make this video extra long. We just want to get some ideas here. So Spotify, I'm not going to go into there. We all know what Spotify is. And if we don't, we've been living under a rock somewhere. Just my opinion, you know. Spotify is one of the top streaming music applications for any mobile device. Basically, you sign up for an account and you could stream music. There are ad breaks if you don't pay for the premium service, although this Spotify can really, really get your jam on with all customized categories and curated music content. So essentially, the next one on the list is TED, and I love TED because TED is a place where you can learn some powerful ideas over here from some of the, you know, public speakers around the world, and, you know, it's just all kinds of things to learn here. This is a very educational app, although it couldn't be a little bit idealistic, so don't take this with truth per se. Always question when you're reading, watching TEDs, because TEDs are not 100% fact. They're not scientific evidence. They're more people, you know, giving inspirational speeches, talking about things they think for the future. It's like a visioning kind of mindset a lot of the people have. But overall, you can learn some great stuff in TED. So I do recommend checking out Voice Recorder. I use Voice Recorder Pro, and I use this app because this allows me to take, you know, audio samples, like when we're doing videos, if I have a phone that dies, I will go over to my Microsoft Lumia here and I will press record and it will start recording, and it seems to save up and work good. And you can also archive your recordings here, so it makes it very enjoyable experience, very clean experience here. I got Beatsio here. Just downloaded this app because I'm still learning how to make beats for future videos. I want to learn how to make my own my beats for the intro. I want it to be my own custom created beat. So currently I'm still trying to play around with these and just get a little gist of how they perform. And, you know, it's a little bit difficult right now, but I thought this was a nice clean app to let you guys know that it is on the, you know, Microsoft Store. It's called Beatsio. So check that one out. Also, I keep a speed test around just to check the Wi-Fi in the area. So if I hop over to the library, I can see just how fast, you know, the speeds are to see if I even want to stay at that library. Maybe I want to go down the block, go to the next library, or go to the Starbucks or something, because the speed's too slow up in that joint. So yeah, that pretty much does that here on a speed test. So you click that and it just starts testing your Wi-Fi speed right here. This has been on Android and iOS for a long time, but Windows Phone has it as well. And it's always a plus to keep this on here. So that was app number 6. Also, I have Traffic Rider. Now, this is basically a motorcycle racing app, and I like speed. I don't know if you've noticed. Talk kind of fast in my videos sometimes. Sorry if I talk too fast for you. But this is a speed racing game here. And basically, it really performs well here on Windows 10 mobile, as well as Windows 8 mobile. So it's a pretty great app, so I'd just like to play this motorcycle app. We're not going to play it here because that would just be taking too much time throughout my video here and your video as well. So let's go into the next one. All right, I'm not going to go into my personalized notes, but Evernote. If you don't know what Evernote is basically an organized note-taking app where you sync your notes across multiple platforms. So you can have Evernote on your desktop, your iOS device, your Windows device, your Android device, and all your notes will be synced up right there. So that's why I have that there. Although this one is not as feature-packed as the one in iOS and Android, you do get quite a bit of power here for your Windows phone, and I think it beats the OneNote application hands down. That's just my opinion. I don't really like how OneNote works. It's just a little bit complex, and it's just, I don't know, it's just not very organized for my eye. You may differ, but that's the beauty of life. We all may differ, but we all are one. Okay, let's go to Dubstep right here. And Dubstep basically is another beat apps. I talked about Beats earlier, but still checking out some more Beats apps. So if you're a music head, check out Dubstep Pad. And then I have Windows Central. Basically, if you've read Android Central, you would know what you would kind of get the gist what Windows Central is. It's basically a news hub for all of the Windows news that is out. So you could see some news here. We're giving away a Lumia 640 XL, which is basically this device blown up. So yeah, go check out this app if you're interested in the Windows phone market. Although it is a declining market and some are saying it is going to die, I think Microsoft has proven their persistence and perseverance over time, and this might change. If they do, they might do something that shocks us all and become, you know, come right back up in the marketplace. So I don't know if it's going to happen, but I'm really hoping for it to happen. So basically, those are my top 10 apps for Windows 10 Mobile. If you have any app suggestions, please drop them down below in the comments so we could help other people out in having the best Windows phone experience for themselves and, you know, to make a better ecosystem and possibly even bring more people over to the platform. Personally, it's not advanced enough for me right now. They don't have as much apps that are, you know, at the top and work out for my life. So I don't keep my SIM card in this Windows phone. But I do from time to time. I'd say maybe 2 days out of the week I use this phone. So basically, that's pretty much going to wrap it up for me. If you guys enjoyed this video, please go ahead and be sure to be the cool guy that leaves it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We got more tech videos coming your way. And share this video with somebody who could find it helpful. Spread the word because trying to grow this channel over here, get more people so we can keep going. And I will catch you all in the next episode. Be sure to be well and peace.